presenting project number one, warm up your audience from the Ubiquitously Speaking Manual, the Advanced Communication Series. The objectives are as follows. Prepare a speech that opens with a humorous story. Personalize the story. Deliver the story smoothly and effectively. Fellow Toastmasters and guests, I present Claudia Mitchell McLeod. You know what happens when you assume.
Toastmasters and guests, let me share with you an experience I had a few years ago. I had been working for the same company for a number of years and sort of thought, as probably many of us have thought at times, that you deserve a raise. Has anybody ever thought you deserved a raise? I thought, I've been at this company for 10 years. I think I deserve a raise. I convinced myself, I thought about the best way to approach my boss, and the day had come when I was going to say, I'd like to speak to you for a moment. And I said, can I speak with you for a moment? I have something I'd like to talk to you about. He said, certainly, come into the office. And I said, I'd like a raise. He said, I'd like to give you. But you know, with the economy being as the economy is, I'm just not able to do that right now. I said, you know, I've been here for 10 years. I think I've brought value to the company. I've made some suggestions that have ultimately ended up in the company saving money. I think I've had a good attitude. I've given my 110%. I think I deserve a raise. As a matter of fact, other companies are after me. He thought about it for a while. And he said, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to give you a raise. Because you have brought value to this company. I know I can count on you. And I don't really, with the economy being as it is, I don't want to have a brain drain. Not only am I going to give you a raise, a 10% raise, I'm going to give you 5 additional days of vacation. What do you think about that? Well, I had to contain myself. You know, we don't want to appear desperate. So I thought, yes! I'm calm. I said, let me think. All right, I will keep working here. The 10%, the 5 additional days of vacation. Thank you so much. As I got ready to leave his office, I am so excited. He said to me, by the way, what companies were after you? I said, funny you should ask. My electric company, my cell phone company, my mortgage company. Thank you very much. An assumption, right? My boss made an assumption. What did my boss assume? Thought I was going to leave, thought I was going to another company, thought I was going to win the competition. What did I assume?
That he would assume that.
Exactly, that he would assume that. It's interesting, you know, that what they say, at least what my mother said, and I don't know whether it was unique to Kansas, that's where my mother was from, but she said, when you assume, do you know how that phrase ends?
Yeah.
How does it end? When you assume. I don't know in that example if you really did. Maybe you just made an ass out of it. You, boss. Because me, employee, I think I did pretty well with that. Right? How many times do we make assumptions? How many of you all have done something and later on found out that it wasn't a good decision because you made an assumption. Has anybody ever done that? Why? Why do you do that? If the boss had gone back, perhaps if he had had a background like mine in journalism, and known about those five W's and the H, you know, the who, what, why, where, when, and how, maybe if he asked that question before, like, who's after you? What companies are interested? How much do they want to pay you? Those kinds of things, perhaps the result would have been different. I suggest that many times before we act, just ask ourselves, are we making any assumptions? Because sometimes when we make an assumption, what they say really is true. When you assume, you make a
assumption.
Thank